Okay. Now continue with 23 problem. Monochromatic radiation emitted when an electron in hydrogen atom jumps from first excited state to the ground state irradiates a photosensitive metal the stopping potential is measured to be 3.57 volt. The threshold frequency is 3.57 volt. The threshold frequency is. Okay. Now, here it is a two concept problem. That means one is atoms and another is photoelectric effect. Okay. Now, first one you take this one. So, electron de-excitation from first state to ground state. So, energy emitted E is equal to E2 minus E1. So, that is given by what is the formula for energy? 1 minute. Okay. So, E is equal to minus 13.6 by N square electron volt. This is our relation for energy. En is equal to. Now here we have to write E2 minus E1. That means minus 13.6 by, sir, taking common, write like minus 13.6 by first excited state to ground. First excited state means N equal to 2 and ground state means N equal to 1. So by 4. Minus of minus 13.6 by 1, or we can write 13.6 into 1 minus 1 by 4, that is 3 by 4 into 13.6, and that we get in electron volt. Now what is the energy of this one? 43.4, that is 10.2 electron volt. This is the energy emitted when electron jumps from first excited state to ground state. Now if this energy, that means this energy is allowed to incident on a photosensitive metal whose so that the stopping potential is measured as 3.57. So now we have the Einstein equation, E is equal to work function plus this one, stopping potential, EV naught. And given that it is, V naught is 3.5 cm. So we can directly write down like this. This energy is 10.2 electron volt. So 10.2 is equal to work function plus electron charge into this one. We get it in electron volt, 3.57. Okay. So volt into electron, it is electron volt. Already this is also an electron volt. So we get W is equal to 10.2 minus 3.57, and that is 6.63 electron volt. Work function is 6.63 electron volts. But we have to calculate threshold frequency. So threshold frequency, so E is equal to h nu naught. Sir, work function is equal to h nu naught. Nu naught is the threshold. So nu naught is equal to work function by h. The work function is 6.63 electron volt. Electron volt means 1.6 10 to the power minus 19 joule divided by h. 6.625 10 power minus 34 joule second. So we cancel out this because it's 6.625, it is 6, so approximately same. So this is approximately 1.6 into 19 and this is minus 15. So 1.6 into 10 to the power 15 hertz. So this is the required answer. Now the 24th one. An electron in the hydrogen atom, jumps from an excited state N to ground state. Excited state N to a ground state. The wavelength emitted is the wavelength emitted illuminates a photosensitive metal. A photosensitive metal having work function 2.75 electron volt. If the stopping potential is 10 volt, the value of N is, jumps from an excited state N to ground state. The wavelength emitted illuminates a photosensitive metal having work function and stopping potential. Then the value of N is reverse to this last problem. That is, we have Einstein equation E is equal to h nu naught plus E b naught. This is work function, this is stopping potential. So this is work function is given as 2.75, W is given as 2.75 and V naught is given as 10 volt. So you can write 2.75 plus 10 because it is in electron volt. If we multiply this 10 with this electron charge, it will get electron volt again. So you can directly write 10 electron volt. So this is 12.75 electron volt. This is the energy incident on the metal. This energy is from the de-excitation of an electron from nth state to ground state. So this E is equal to, we have write En minus E1, and that is minus 13.6 by n square minus 13.6. Minus 13.6 by 1. So we can write it as 13.6 into 1 minus 1 n square. So this energy is equal to this energy. So equating these two. So 13.6 into 1 minus 1 by n square is 12.75. So 1 minus 1 by n square equal to 12.75 by 13.6. So 1 by n square is equal to 1 minus 12.7 by 13.6. This is 13.6 minus 12.75 by 13.6. And this is 0.85 by 13.6. You take reverse of this. 1 by n square is equal to n square is equal to 13.6 by 0.85. Actually, this is 16 times, so n is 4. Now 25, the radiation corresponding to the radiation corresponding to 3-2-2 transition of hydrogen atom falls on a metal surface to produce photoelectrons The electrons are made to enter into a magnetic field of 3 into 10 power minus 4 Tesla. 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 Tesla. If the radius, if the radius of largest circular path largest circular path followed by the electron, largest circular path followed by the electron is 10 millimeter. Full stop. The work function of the metal. The work function of the metal is okay. The radiation corresponding to 3-2-2 transition of hydrogen atom falls on a metal surface to produce photoelectrons. These electrons are made to enter a magnetic field of this much strength. If the radius of the largest circular path is 10 millimeter, then the work function is, how can calculate is, first E 3 to E 2 transition. This is the energy released in the transition, and that equal to minus 13.6 by 9 minus of minus 13.6 by 4. That is 13.6 into 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9. That is 13.6 into 5 by 36. And this is 1.89 electron volt. Okay, now this is the energy of the photon which is incident on the metal surface. Now the electrons are released from the metal surface, and those electrons are allowed to pass through a magnetic field. So actually this energy 1.89 is equal to work function plus kinetic energy. Okay, now this, with this kinetic energy, they enter into a magnetic field where they follow the circular path of radius 10 mm. So when they move in a circular path, that means mv square by r is equal to bqv. Force due to magnetic field is equal to the centripetal force. So we can cancel out this v, means radius of the orbit is okay, or we can calculate mv is equal to bqr. Okay, now this is the momentum of the body, momentum of the electron. Now we have to calculate kinetic energy. So kinetic energy means p is equal to bqr. We have kinetic energy K is equal to P square by 2m. That is B square, E square, you take Q is equal to E, charge of electron, because, or we can write here itself BeV. B square E square R by 2m. Okay, now this kinetic energy is equal to stopping potential. Okay, 1 minute. Isn't 1 minute? Now, substituting all these values, we can calculate kinetic energy. So, K is equal to B value square, means this one, that is 9 into 10 to the power minus 4 minus 8. Next, electron charge square. That is 1.6 into 10 to the power. 1 minute. Okay, 1 minute. Now we can calculate this kinetic energy. Actually, all these substituting all these values, we get in joule. Suppose if we divide it by charge of electron, we get in electron volts, directly in electron volts. So we can write the same. That is, K is equal to B square E R by 2m electron volt. Okay, directly we can write minus 19 into radius is 10. Sorry, R square is also there. So 10 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square. Divided by 2 into 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. So this is 9 into 1.6 into, here it is 10 to the power minus 2 to the power minus 4, minus 4 minus 8 minus 12 minus 12 into minus 12 minus 19 minus 31 divided by 2 into 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31. These will get cancelled. And this we get as 0.79 electron volt. Now substitute here, we get work function is equal to 1.89 minus kinetic energy, 1.89 minus 0.79, that is 1.1 electron volt. Consider a hydrogen-like ionized atom. Ionized atom with atomic number Z. With atomic number Z. With single electron. With single electron. In the emission spectrum. In the emission spectrum. In the emission spectrum. Of this atom, photon emitted in the n equal to 2 to n equal to 1 has energy 74.8 electron volt higher than photon emitted n equal to 3 to n equal to 2. The ionization energy is 13.6 electron volt. Then the value of Z is, so this is integer type question. Okay. So consider hydrogen-like ionizer atom with atomic number Z with a with a single electron, the emission spectrum of this atom, photon emitted from N2-2 transition is 74 electron volt higher than the transition from N2-3. The ionization energy is 13.6, then the value of Z is. So, first calculate 2-2-1 transition. So, E2 minus E1 in this transition 13.6 by square. So, 4 minus of minus 13.6 by 1, that is 13.6 into 1 minus 1 by 4, that is 3 by 4, 13.6. This is the first one. So, 3-2-2 transition, that is E3 to E2. In this transition, we can directly write 13.6 into 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9. That is 13.6 into 5 by 36. Okay. Now, this transition is 74.8 higher than this value. So, that means, 1 minute, where we got wrong value? Oh, 1 minute. Here we have to actually, E is equal to minus 13.6 into Z square by N square. It is not hydrogen atom, okay. Sorry. It is atomic number Z is there. So, we have to write here minus Z square into 13.6. So, into Z square here. Here also, we have to write Z square into this one. That is here also Z square. So, now this value is 74.8 higher than this value. So, you can write that 3 by 4, 13.6 Z square is equal to 5 by 36, 13.6 plus 74.8, sorry, into Z square plus 7. So, writing Z square terms on same side, 13.6 Z square into 3 by 4 minus 5 by 36 is equal to 74.8. So, Z square into 13.6 into, this is 36, 9, 9, 3, 27 minus 5. To 74.8. So, Z square is equal to 13.6 into 22 by 36 is equal to 74.8. So, Z square is equal to 74.8 into 36 by 22 into 13.6. So, if we simplify this one, we will get 9 and Z equal to 3.